In this video, we're going to look at operations with rational expressions. First, we're going to look at simplifying rational expressions. In the example below, we have the rational expression x squared minus 4 times x squared minus x over x squared minus 2x times x squared plus 4x plus 4. Our first step in simplifying this is to factor all polynomial expressions. X squared minus 4 factors as x plus 2 times x minus 2. That's a difference of squares. X squared minus x, there's a common factor of x that we can factor out and write as x times x minus 1. In the denominator, we can factor an x out of x squared minus 2x to get x times x minus 2. And x squared plus 4x plus 4 is a trinomial that factors as x plus 2 times x plus 2. Okay, now we look for common factors. We see that there's a factor of x plus 2 in the numerator and the denominator. These will cancel out. We see an x minus 2 in the numerator and also an x minus 2 in the denominator. These cancel out. There is an x in the numerator and also a factor of x in the denominator. These cancel out. All that we have left now is x minus 1 over x plus 2, and that's our final answer. In this next example, we're going to multiply rational expressions. Here we're going to multiply the rational expression x squared minus 4 over x squared minus 2x times the rational expression x squared minus x over x squared plus 4x plus 4. Our first step here, just like in the last problem, is to factor all rational expressions. The x squared minus 4 factors as the difference of squares, x plus 2 times x minus 2. X squared minus x factors as x times x minus 1. We just factored out the greatest common factor of x. And x squared minus 2x factors as x times x minus 2. And x squared plus 4x plus 4 factors as x plus 2 times x plus 2. Now we cancel out factors common to the numerator and denominator. Here we have x plus 2 and x plus 2. They cancel out. A factor of x minus 2 cancels with a factor of x minus 2 in the denominator, and a factor of x cancels with x. And what we're left with is x minus 1 over x plus 2. And you're probably saying, hey, wait a minute, we just did this problem. Well, almost. When you multiply rational expressions, it's almost exactly the same as simplifying one big rational expression. We end up with the same answer, x minus 1 over x plus 2. Now here's an example where we divide two rational expressions. We're dividing the rational expression x squared minus x minus 12 over x plus 5 by x squared minus 16 over x plus 3. The very first step in this operation is to invert that second fraction we're dividing by and rewrite it as a multiply problem. So we're rewriting it as times x plus 3 over x squared minus 16. Make sure and do this first. Now factor all expressions that you can factor. The x squared minus x minus 12 factors as x minus 4 times x plus 3. The difference of squares, x squared minus 16 factors as x plus 4 times x minus 4. And now we look for common factors, numerator and denominator, and we find one pair of common factors. The x minus 4s can cancel out, and the x plus 3s can't cancel out, although you might be tempted to do so. What we're left with is x plus 3 times x plus 3 over x plus 4 times x plus 5. And we can write that as x plus 3 quantity squared over x plus 4 times x plus 5. Now we're going to look at adding two rational expressions. In our example here, we're adding the rational expression 1 over x minus 2 to x plus 1 over x minus 1. And to do this, we have to get the same denominator in both rational expressions. Just like you're adding 1 half plus 1 third, you have to get a common denominator of 6. It's minus 1. The least common denominator, or LCD for short, is the smallest denominator such that each denominator is a factor. Well, the denominator x minus 2 is a factor of this least common denominator. It's right here, x minus 2. Also, x minus 1 is a factor right here. So that's our least common denominator. Now we have to multiply each fraction by a special form of 1 in order to get that denominator in each fraction. The first fraction we multiply by x minus 1 over x minus 1. Well, x minus 1 over itself is 1, so we're not changing the value of that fraction. The second fraction we multiply by x minus 2 over x minus 2. That's also a special form of 1. Well, when we do that multiplication, we get our first fraction turning into x minus 1 over x minus 2 times x minus 1. Our second fraction turns into x squared minus x minus 2 over x minus 2 times x minus 1. And that trinomial x squared minus x minus 2 is the product x plus 1 times x minus 2 all foiled out. Now we have two fractions with common denominators. We can combine them by adding their numerators together. We add the x minus 1 to the x squared minus x minus 2, put all of that over our common denominator, and then we can just simplify that, and the numerator simplifies to x squared minus 3 all over our common denominator of x minus 2 times x minus 1. And I have a note at the bottom here. If your rational expressions need to be factored, you should do so before even starting to find the least common denominator. In this case, there was no factoring that needed to be done.